Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Ron McKenzie Lafergie. LBQ is on Patreon now. It's linked down below and stay tuned to the end to hear more about how you can help out. We've all been there. You're rifling through some pages and suddenly, paper cut. It's annoying, it bleeds, and worst of all, it hurts way more than it should. But why does such a small cut hurt so damn much? Let's explore. Get ready, it's time to ask the question, why do small paper cuts hurt so much? First of all, we should probably iron down how the heck the seemingly innocent paper can go on to maim people around the world. While paper is an excellent writing tool, allowing us to record our thoughts and ideas, ushering us into a new era of humanity, it's also super thin. The average piece of paper is roughly 0.05 millimeters thick, several times thinner than the blade on most kitchen knives. While the pressure on the skin is very low due to the flimsiness of the paper, the surface area is extremely small. At the proper angle, and particularly when held in place by other sheets, paper acts similar to a handsaw, slicing through skin and leaving an incredibly fine cut. And contrary to what one would believe, thin cuts can be some of the most painful. But why is this? Well, the skin is covered with nociceptors, tiny pain receptors that send pain signals to the brain when stimulated. Since paper cuts activate a relatively large number of nociceptors over a relatively small area, it seems as if the pain felt is disproportionate to the injury. This is further exacerbated by the fact that paper cuts tend to occur on the fingers, for obvious reasons, and fingers tend to have some of the highest concentrations of nociceptors in the entire body. The lack of blood also affects both the pain felt and our perception of said pain. Paper cuts tend to bleed rather little since the cut itself is rather thin. The lack of blood causes more pain receptors to be left uncovered in the air, which increases the pain experienced. At the same time, a lack of blood makes us feel like the cut shouldn't be hurting as much as it does. As it turns out, while we may associate a lack of blood with a less severe injury, in this case, a bit of blood would make it feel a whole lot better. Finally, the properties of the paper itself can often make a paper cut hurt worse than stepping on a Lego. Paper is often bleached to whiten it, and the bleach can cause further irritation to the paper cut. This brings up an important point. While paper cuts may seem benign, they can cause a problem if not treated properly. Generally, paper cuts aren't an issue. With so little surface area, it's pretty easy to keep clean. But in the right circumstances, paper cuts can lead to cellulitis, a bacterial infection, or even necrosis, or cell death. So keep your cuts clean, folks, because it's all fun and games until someone loses a finger. Now we return to our question, why do small paper cuts hurt so much? Well, it seems that the thin slice received from a paper cut creates something of a perfect storm for pain. It activates large amounts of nociceptors in a small area. The limited bleeding leaves the wound open to air. Not to mention the chemicals in the paper itself can make things even worse. So chin up, be careful handling paper, and clean those cuts if you know what's best for you. Or don't. I mean, they are just paper cuts. Thank you for watching Life's Biggest Questions. I hope this was interesting and informative, and maybe even inspired you to look into it further on your own. If you like this video, please thumbs up and subscribe to the channel down below. While you're down there, check out our new Patreon linked in the description. It's completely voluntary, but if you would like to help to support this channel and have a hand in the direction of the channel and selection of the videos, this is the best way to do so. Until next time, I'm Ron McKenzie Lafergie with Life's Biggest Questions, wishing you the best of luck on your quest for answers.